I sure hope that there's a wedge in here too. I don't think so though, because that's definitely a Square Enix thing. Forget the chest. Try checking your inventory and character bios as indicated in the bottom right corner of the screen. Private Biggs and Private Wedge! Oh my gosh! Silver Rook. She mentioned button immersion. Broken. Good morning. Well, hello, Mr. Red. How you doing? Look, it is Biggs and Wedge! I love this game already. I'm surprised. Hey, cool. What's going on? How you doing? So I can hit V. This is my inventory, it looks like. The skull icon represents Helion, the currency used to buy and sell items. The scale icon represents capacity. So I'm already at 35 out of 100 capacity. Alright, before suffering the overweight debuff. Okay, each section of your inventory categorizes items by the same type. Okay. Most items can be sold to merchants or removed from your inventory. However, some quest items will remain with you. Okay, obviously. Relics represented by the diamond icon may be equipped to improve stats or upgrade skills. Some quest items may also be equipped. Alright. So I got nothing. Let's see. B. What is B? This is the bio, so I can learn about my team members. Left or right between the characters in your team. Health. The flame mic is bigger. Sword is combat. This is slate. So the key is how crafty they are. Mercantry represents the character's ability to negotiate with merchants. Awareness. Our success determined by the ally with the highest rating. And the tent indicates overwatch and represents the character's ability to care for the party while camping. Okay. Is Twyla timed out? Twyla is timed out because we're mad at Twyla. Where is it? Silence Twyla. There we go. We're not mad at Twyla anymore. She can be unsilenced. Doing some planning. Nice. Cool. All right. So, Mr. Red, what games do you play? Have you been playing this one? Combat skills can be performed while fighting. Normal skills are your character's default abilities. Flourish skill can only be used once it's been charged with flourish points. Okay. I'm going to skip through a little bit of this stuff here. So I've got Strike, Prey, and Warcry for him. Okay. And then M, the map. The map displays your current location. Really? Man, that's amazing. I had no idea. Looks like there's three rooms. All right. I already got the goodies. Can I run faster if I hit shift or control? Nope. All right, we're going to go through the next door. Hey, Pavic, good morning. Very short snapshot. Yeah, this is just a quick snapshot of the game. It's normally $25, I think, $24.99. It's on sale, I think, for $19.99. I think, don't kill me. Let's see here. Let me pull that up real quick and find out. So I can give you guys some good information. Let's see here. Yeah, $24.99 normally, and it's on sale for $19.50. So, and it's only on sale for the next half an hour. So, if you're interested, I like the art style; looks pretty cool. All right, Wedge, did you forget to bring your geistometer again? We should keep going. No use going back all the way if we came this far. Oh, we came if they are going back the way we came. If they are okay. Stay put for too long and they'll catch up. Remember, if your health or vigor drops to zero, we'll be the ones spooking this place. Let's go. Alright, so you have to keep an eye on your health and vigor. I feel uneasy. This place gives me the creeps. You know what, Biggs? Yeah. Okay, so guys, if your health gets to zero, then you turn into a ghost. Damage to health is usually incurred during combat. Okay. Yellow bar is their vigor, so it's basically stamina, I would assume. Occurred through stress of exploration. So if we... You gain flourish points through critical action bonuses and finishing turns during combat. Okay. Alright, so let's see what we got here. Combat! A totem. You spring a trap. It's dangerous! Watch your feet! Spring a trap that spreads infrasicon? Infrasonic. Jeez, I'm... infrasonic waves causing you a strange tension. I have minus 2 health and hand tremors. Alright. Another trap. Best to have someone with a high awareness stat in your team to avoid them. Okay, well I don't have someone with a high awareness right now. You don't play this, but I've been playing Beat Hazard 2 more than anything. I have not played Beat Hazard. Either one of them. Is it fun? Obviously, if you're playing it, it is. Well, warn your party of imminent dangers. Okay, so do I have to have someone... Characters with low awareness will trigger traps more easily. Of course. Some actions have a probability of failure. When you see this green script, it means your attempt was a success. Red script means you failed! Green means you missed and the enemy has evaded your attack. And that's a crit, okay? Basics. Basics. So I just lost health then with that totem. Wedge, I just saw something move in the distance. Get your weapons ready and think fast, alright? Let's make sure we all get home today. So how do I don't even know how to fight. I don't know how the combat system is. This will be interesting. You've encountered hostile enemies. Your team is located on the left and the enemy is on the right. Okay. Each team has 4 slots, so I only have 3 slots and there's only 3 enemies. Okay. Rising in value from the center, the team's character hugs have slight slot icons denoting their space. Okay. Is this really loud to you guys? Because, holy cow, it's really loud in my ear. I gotta take the earbud out. Displays turn order. Okay, higher awareness gives characters an advantage in initiative. 2 characters have the same awareness. The one positioned in front will get initiative. Okay. Normal skills are your character's default abilities. The flourish is powerful, but needs to be charged by accumulating points, which they already said so. Okay. Cannot use items or change relics during combat. Runaway is a good option for avoiding combat. And I can change formation during combat. Okay. So monster types. Alright, alright. So this looks like these are her abilities. Let's try. There are 3 range types for every skill. Short range, mid range, and long range. Okay. Short range skills are only available. Okay, makes sense. Mid range. Okay. And long range. Okay. Choose your target. Your target is visible on the enemy HUD. You can also speed up the pace of combat. Okay. Oh, by hit and shift. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and attack this guy. So how do I... Oh, that was a punch. That didn't work. Oh yeah, it did. Boom, you dead, son. Alright. Wedge, what you gonna do for me? We're gonna do... attack. And you get to attack this guy right here. Oh, it didn't work. Alright. Biggs. No, you're Wedge. You're Wedge. We're gonna attack again. What is Q? What does this do? I don't know what that ability... Can I see what these abilities actually do? Alright. Looks good. We'll do this. Oh. I think that lowered his defenses. And he looks really mad to me because he just got a little skull above him. So he's mad. Alright, you can throw your ninja stars at this first guy. Oh, we got a package, Vorty. That's a package. Beat Hazard 2 is fun. You can play along to any sort of music. So is it like Beat Saber then? Yes.
Funny because the dog can't have his room. Alright, how's it going?
Oh, maybe it wasn't. Now Vordy's got to talk. Oh, hold on. Now the barking ensues. Oh, maybe it won't bark. All right, we're going to attack this guy. Let's do it. Smash his face. Yeah, you did it. Weird when you have, yeah, it's kind of interesting. Like, I'm assuming what these So shift and I can nope, I can't. Sorry, Vordy, that wasn't a package. Little delayed in realizing someone's here. Hold on, guys. One second. Oh. Okay, had to put him in the other room. Poor puppers. He's a little delayed in realizing that, he's a little late in realizing that someone was here. Now he's still barking, but okay. Told you guys I had a bad feeling about this place. Well, you know what, Biggs? You're a little late in saying that. Also, you play these games? Oh, okay. Wait, you actually worked on Yotun? Really? But the man in the channel was ignoring my messages when I was talking. So we did see that, we did see you talking yesterday. I don't think it was necessarily that he was ignoring you. I think it was more so the fact that, he was really engrossed in the game. And welcome back, TDW. I did see you yesterday talking in channel. How are you doing today? And so what did you do, for the game? That's amazing. And sorry if you can hear the doggo. He's a psycho. It's like Beat Saber because the music affects the gameplay. It's not as engaging as Beat Saber. The music affects the bullets you shoot and how intense the lights. It's hard to describe. Okay, I'm going to have to check that out. Mr. Red, are you in our Discord by any chance? If you want to, there's a section in there for games to check out. Would love to... You could put that in there for, so I could check that out and look. That'd be awesome. Top three games of Sekiro, Metro Exodus. Okay, so someone was talking about Sekiro just recently. And of course, Metro Exodus. I heard that's great. I know I've seen quite a few people streaming that. By all means, continue quarreling amongst yourselves if you want to be ice pops. Ice pops, really. We had the spoils we came for, and it's colder than a witch's tit out here. I, for one, am ready to return. Guys, it is colder than a witch's tit. That would be awesome, Mr. Red. I'd appreciate that. Hold up, guys. I see a body. It looks like a girl. So wait, if it was a guy, she was just going to leave it, but because it's a girl, she's going to check up on it. Wedge is like, hey, who is it? Hey, hubba bubba. All right, we're going to interact with her. She's not from Dalark. I don't recognize her, and no other scavenging teams came up today either. Thank you, Mr. Red. I appreciate that. We can't help her now. Search the body. Oh, what? Already, I just saw your comment, Rook, about the postman leaving the package at the gas station. For those of you that don't know, this is a while ago. My husband, it's a long story, kind of, but he went to the gas station to go get pop for us and ended up walking home and forgetting that he left my vehicle up there at the gas station. I don't know how you managed to do that, but he did. Seriously, you search her. Wait, she's still breathing. We should help her. Who knows how long she's been out here? You want to bring her back? Are you mad? We have no clue who she is. She could be with the Green Flame for all we know. So I guess the Green Flame is the bad guys. She doesn't look like one of them. Can't risk compromising Dalark's location. Celeste will have our heads. What if she knows how to cast that strange magic? We don't have time. We don't have to worry about that. She's unconscious. Captain Lanville shall decide her fate. Yeah, you like that, Mr. Rudd? Looks like it's your lucky day, girl. All right. Ooh, I got an achievement.
I once read a man would have to go below the waves to.
Oh, I'll tell you the story, more details in just a second.
Reminds me of you, dear father. I confess I never really knew you. After all, how does one get the measure of a man when there's so much beneath the surface? Nevertheless, I owe my survival of Zumurud's blistering deserts and the wild forests of Sylvia to your training. When I was summoned home to
Edina, TDW, what was it that you did on your last Yotun? Is that how it's pronounced, I think?
I didn't know what to expect. I suppose it comes as no surprise. You remained a mystery, even in
death.
That's
amazing, though.
I now find myself beckoned to the dwarven realm of Dokheim by the encrypted journal and ancient relic you left
behind. I love the animation of this game.
On
this
an expedition
awesome.
To the cursed city of Isenir for answers you never provided. I shall not be daunted. My determination is equal to the task at hand. If, as you say, this Vambrace is the key to entering that forbidden city. I will find what I seek. My journey has been difficult. Since the Vambrace entered my possession, I have been plagued by unsettling dreams of a ghostly blade cutting me down.
The Adventures with two S's. Adventures, guys. All right. Ooh, so we got a hottie boom body. Sleeping Beauty. She is a pretty girl. Let's make this clear. I'm the one asking questions here. You can start with your name. I'm assuming this is Captain Lanville. I think they said his name was. My name is Lyric. Avelia Lyric. Okay. Yeah, you like that? Adventuress? So a female adventure? Okay. Good call there, Rook. Lanville Esquire. You're lucky we found you. A moment later and you'd be another piece of frozen decor gracing the streets like it was here today. I must have fainted. I've never felt a chill like that before. We are unfortunately well acquainted with it here. Celeste had half a mind to leave you up there. Good for you. She's not calling the shots, and I was feeling generous. Up there. So, we're underground. King on my list. So... yeah, did he want to buy your truck? Looks like I've got a sharp one on my hands.
I'm always nice to him, though, because I know they get door slammed in their face. So
I took the liberty. I know, Deadly. Man, let me use those hacks. Deadly says, big streamers should be allowed to use hacks without permissions.
Really?
Repressions. So, how are you doing, TDW, if you're still here? I took the liberty of searching your stuff. A bunch of climbing gear and a strange book nobody can read. Explain. Uh-oh. Going through her stuff? Come on, how mean is that? I came seeking answers about my father, the late Dr. Niccolo Lyric. Wait, Oh, that's her name. That's right. I traveled here from Edna with his journal. Yeah, Gond, what's going on? How you doing? Yes, I am still awake. This game looks really cool and I really wanted to try it, so... Everyone knows nobody goes in and nobody ever comes out of Isenair? Isenair, you mean I'm here? I actually made it inside the city? Suppose for a moment I entertain your absurd story. How the hell did you get past the Frostfell? The barrier around the city? I walked right through it. Enough of this nonsense. You think I haven't seen what happens when someone touches it? Instant death. The only freaks wandering the surface are either spooks, mad survivors, or the green flame. You're not dead, and far as I can tell, you're still sane. So let's cut through the crap. What's your connection with the green flame? Sparkle's ruler of the Glitter Kingdom. He is outside talking with Jehovah's Witness, apparently, because I told him that we had an Amazon package here. Do I say I don't know them or it sounds familiar, guys? What do you think? I'm kind of thinking I want to say sounds familiar, but I don't know them. I'm so mean. This is basically all one-handed play with my just left hand. Kind of interesting. Let's do... Look like you can use a snack. No, I'm pretty good. I had a nice breakfast. It was pretty interesting. And I'll tell you guys more about that in just a moment as well. So I have to tell you about the car that he left at the gas station and about breakfast. It was pretty funny. All right, sounds familiar. You mean that crazy Arcanic cult? That crazy cult wiped out the most prosperous city in Dokheim overnight. They're not to be taken lightly. They're the ones responsible for this frozen curse? I can assure you I'm not with them. I just got here. You're serious, aren't you? Well, imagine my surprise to learn that some Edney decided to take a leisure stroll on the surface. Listen, I have a... You jerk. Matter of great urgency, I'm looking for an individual named Zagard.
Brutal Titan. Do you know of him? This card. Here, this will hold you over.
No, he didn't leave it again. So Pillar has not heard the story of Vorti. Okay, what happened? Hold on, let me get a jelly bean. Vorti went to go to the gas station to go get us drinks. What is it? Oh, it's bubblegum. They mixed up some random ones in this because bubblegum is not supposed to be in this box. It's tasty though. Thank you, Brutal. I appreciate it. So, he went to go get his drinks at the gas station. Then he walked up there, realized he left his wallet at home. Mind you, before he left, I said, make sure you take a wallet, mine or his, whatever. So he walked home, grabbed his wallets, grabbed the keys to my vehicle, hopped in the vehicle, went back up to the gas station. And then walked home and left my vehicle there. Then, yeah, Dago's not thrilled. I am Twyla. I am the wife of VorticoastLine 75. He is taking a quick break right now, so I figured I'd start the stream for him with this game because I wanted to play this game. And then he's going to do another, I think it's another smaller game called Pray to the Gods. Yeah. So, he left my vehicle. So, he didn't realize it. So, he comes home, gives me my drink and everything, and he's outside on the porch smoking. And then, he freaks out. Twyla, where's your vehicle? I think someone stole your vehicle. And then he, like, disappears. And I'm like, oh my gosh, what happened? So, finally, I stopped the stream. I said, hold on, guys, I gotta go check on Vorti, because he, like, disappeared for, like, 10 minutes. And I step outside on the porch, and it's him. Coming back, and he's out of breath because he'd ran all the way back up to the gas station and then drove the car back. Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. It was absolutely ridiculous. No, I'm not making up stories. I would love to make up stories. Okay, so then today we went to McDonald's for breakfast. Sat down and ate a sandwich, and we had Vorty's mom there as well. Hold on. There's nothing left for us to discuss right now, but I'm feeling gracious today, so tell you what. I'm giving you tentative permission to move about Dale Ark until I figure out what to do with you. That is Dale Ark? Oh, that's the name of our lovely abode deep below Isonair. Welcome to paradise. You're just letting me go? There's nowhere to run, so you'd best make yourself at home. In fact, take this. You'll need some if you want to survive down here. Ooh, giving her cash, too? What's this? We call it Halion, and it's the only currency worth anything down here. Consider it a little welcome gift. I've never seen paper money. Try anything funny, and you're dead. In a cell, or right back on the surface where we found you. Are we clear? Crystal. Okay. So we go there, and Vorty's mother, she ordered a sausage cheese biscuit sandwich, no egg on it. And they gave her an egg and cheese biscuit sandwich with no sausage. Exactly what she didn't want. So she takes it back up there and says, I'm sorry, I can't have egg. Can you please make one with sausage on it? So then they took it back and then they handed her another one. And it was a biscuit with just cheese on it. And she said, she got so pissed. She was like about to flip her lid. And Vorty and I are just sitting there laughing our asses off like, yeah. So then she takes it back up and then they finally brought her her correct sandwich. But yeah, like anything but normal. Okay, so Lyric is famished. Is there anything to eat down here? You can run while you're in derelict, so I have to hit the shift button. All right. Come on. Oh. This is the codex. I've separated it into two sections, the codex and the journal. Okay. It contains details on your current mission and goal, left and right between completed and working mission sections. Okay. So that's this one. This is the codex. It's separated into two sections. So it talks about her father. Unlock its encrypted pages to learn more about the world, its history, and other mysteries. Okay. Press up and down to check the pages within. Okay, cool. Simple enough. Change books to view the journal. It contains details on your current mission and goal. So I think right now my only mission is to really just exit the prison, find somewhere to eat. All right, so let's do this. Your progress has been saved. Yeah. Yeah, it was absolutely ridiculous, I'm telling you. Captain's finished with you, eh? That was fast. Please wait while I process your paperwork. Don't process my paperwork. Let me walk around. Ooh. Keep your distance from her or you're bound to lose a limb. That's Isabel Salazar. The woman knows black magic. Consider yourself warned. I want her on my team. Hey. What's with all the hottie boom body chicks? I can't place her, but for some reason she looks so familiar. You know what? Are you being a punk? The Frostwind howls around you. Your presence here will bring much anguish. What? I don't understand. Your paperwork is done. Scram before we change your mind. I want to keep talking to her. Oop. Let's look at this. How to keep your body warm. Step 1, make a fire. Step 2, stand in front of the fire. Step 3, be warm. Guys, that is how to keep your body warm, apparently. Best to keep your distance from her, lest you get hexed. The witch knows black magic. Consider yourself warned. What's with all the hot, skinny chicks? Would you want some meat? That's kind of what I'm thinking, Mr. Red. Really? Come on, ladies. Let's be real here. I cannot go downstairs into the dungeon. We're gonna go up and try and find some food. Oh, whoa. Okay. I really like the animation for this game. This is really cute. We're gonna go right here. Need them thick Norse, ladies. Yeah. Step 1, bathing gasoline. Step 2, buy matches. Step 3, you figure it out. What, do you throw the unlit matches in the gasoline, right? Halt! You're not allowed to be roaming around here. Yes, I am. I've got some monies. Calm yourself, good sir. This is my dear friend. Do you not recognize her? He's got ears. Another girl, eh? You tricky bastard. I still need to check her papers, though. Are you really gonna check her papers when I'm trying to go to the bar? Come on. No need to bother. I could personally vouch for her. After all, a friend of mine is a friend of the North Venture Company. All right, go on. Who is this smooth talker? Move along. Guard doesn't want to talk to me. Mahoram. What gorgeous eyes the lady has. Mahoram, relic hunting, extraordinaire, at your service. Oh, it's just a couple blocks. It's not far at all. It's definitely within walking distance. Is the music too loud? There we go. Sorry, but isn't that just a fancy way to say you're a thief of antiquities? Ooh, busted. You offend my sensibilities with such barbed words. I'm merely a humble adventurer who got stuck in the wrong place at the wrong time. Thanks for defending me at the market gate. My name is Lyric. I do like that name. I think that's pretty cute for a girl. Why did you help me anyways? I have a quick ear, m'lady. Life here can be difficult for an outlander unfamiliar with our strange ways. Ah, forgive me. You must be famished. Allow me to take you to the market. So, what is so strange about their ways? What, that they use fire to keep warm? That they are unusually skinny for people who live in this frozen wasteland? I don't know. That's one offer I won't refuse. Come then, follow me. Alright, let's go follow the guy. Oh. Get some food. It's almost 11 o'clock, or almost noon. We got about 5 minutes till. That's what it looks like, kind of, Rook. Super Mario Bros. 2. Nice, Mr. Red. And I don't know how... There's so many funny clips, guys. Hello, Yasol. This is Lyric, a dear friend of mine. My dear friend since today. She's gawking at me. Oh, she's jealous. Yasol, huh? That's a pretty name. How can I help you two today? What? Do you need to... Okay, guys. I need to take a quick break. Give me just 1 second. Doggo is going crazy again, and I think Morty needs something. Give me 1 minute. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you being here. Hold on. Know exactly if this is going to be an anime-ish game or not. I think it might be like all scene-based. Do you have anything to eat? I can pay in gold. We don't use gold here, m'lady. Don't you have any hellion? Hellion? The fox, you traditionally burnt it as an offering to our ancestors. It's now the currency of choice for spooks. Ooh. You mean this, right? Lanville gave me some. Great. Shall we make a deal? So she accepted it. Achievement unlocked. Anything in particular you're looking for? Daylight survivors are sober, and sober wraiths conduct trade using a paper currency called Hellion. You'll need to scavenge and sell supplies you found on the field to earn more. You are fine. You need to stop. Switch between the shopwares and your inventory to buy and sell items. I don't think I need to buy anything yet. Merchantry represents your ability to negotiate with merchants. The more options and rare items you will appear in the shop if you have a high merchantry stat. Okay, so I need different people for different... I know, I love the different eye colors. That's just my thing. So here's the funny thing. I'm like kind of blind in my eye. So I'm supposed to wear a contact in this eye, and this eye is perfect vision. So I always wanted to have one color contact in this eye, but I never did. Gecko tail skewer. Some tea prevents hypothermia. So you actually can get cold and die of cold out here. All right. Fire brew smelling salts. Bring you back from the dead, it looks like. Oh, so you don't hear the dog whining? He's a pain in the butt, I'm telling you. You want to see? Here. Doggo. Doggo, come here. Hey. It's dog food. This is Puppy. He is a... he's a Tring Walker Coonhound. He looks like a gigantic beagle. Are you going to be good boy? Come here. Come here. I'll give you this.
English foxhound.
Yes, he's a descendant of an English foxhound, but he's a big, big boy. I mean, he's 90 pounds. He's a big boy. One more? Come on up. And he dropped it. He's also a klutz. He looks like a big beagle, but he's not. I'll be seeing you around. Yes, Shinigami, this is the deal for, like, another minute. Actually, I do need to take him outside, so give me just one moment. I'm sorry, guys. Hold on 1 second. So, if you're interested in a different face on the screen... Oh, you mean the fighters. I thought you meant you were sick and tired of seeing my face. I was like, don't worry, he'll be here in just a moment. It's random, except the ones that you can pick are the emotes from this channel. So, any of Vorty's emotes, you can use those for fighters. You type exclamation point and no space. You just type the name of the actual emote or any of Twitch's emotes. But if it's specific for any other channel, it doesn't recognize it for some reason. Sadly. But yes, you can use It's Bushi Time. One more second, guys. Hold on.